the opinion of the court is, the filing of the OP itself is an abuse of process of court. There is a clear collision between one respondent, first respondent, and Vijayanand, secretary of the second respondent. Yeah. And both of them did not come to the court with clean hands and suppress true facts. And then it goes on to say that the respondent numbers 1 and 2 wanted to delay the appointment of the ombudsman and ethics officer and to embarrass Justice Deepak Verma, former judge of the Supreme Court. So the PSROP number 17 of 2020 itself is dismissed, as its continuance might lead to commission of further fraud and mischief by the first respondent and R. Vijayanand, the secretary of the second respondent, and others supporting them. The others supporting them are the other four people. There's John Manoj, Narendra Sharma, Surinda Garwal, and Anuradha. So this is the order which is given by the Honorable High Court. On this order only, and they have been fined also, both the budding star and the other, and Vijayana has been fined 25,000 rupees, fine, and they have to pay in the court. And then also it is very clear that the, I mean, about the Apex Council thing, you know everything about the ombudsman thing. Because, yeah, because the court has also said that it is therefore clear that Sri Vijayanand, secretary of the second respondent, having agreed to a particular decision in the Apex Council meeting held on 6-11-2020 in the presence of all members of the Apex Council, clandestinely arranged another meeting on the same day with himself, Sundar Kumar, the treasurer, John Manoj, the president, Naresh Sharma, the joint secretary, and Councillor Anuradha behind the back of the president, Mohammad Azharuddin, and got order passed and got passed another resolution and passed it off as the Apex Council meeting resolution and deliberately misled the court below to help the first respondent get the impugned interim order. It is much clearer, everything much clearer than that. Who is doing what, everybody knows. I am here to clear everything, whatever happens. See, I want to ask everybody who is sitting here, why for the last 25 years only these people are holding positions in the association? Why can't the other secretaries hold the positions as well? Because they need to, for the last 25 years, they do all those blackmailing tactics, which I am not going to cow down to those things. Because I have played cricket at the highest level, I have played with a lot of dignity, I have done everything for the best for the country. And I am not going to cow down to this blackmailing tactics, which I think has been happening for the last 20-25 years. Because why only these people are only in the committees? Why not others? There are others also who are there, I mean, who are deserving. But then this blackmailing practice has to end, because if it doesn't happen now, I mean, it will never happen, Hyderabad cricket will never improve. I mean, for the last 25 to 30 years, this has been happening. And I really want to do something for the game of cricket. What am I mean, every day something somebody says about me, that something, I've been banned and do whatever, suspended. Why am I taking all this? I'm only taking it because I love the game, I love the cricket, I love cricket of Hyderabad. Because I've been brought up here, I've played on this ground many times and I've done so much. It pains me to see that, you know, these things are not happening properly. And what about these people are talking about cricket? What have they played cricket? Please tell me, I want to ask anybody. If anybody has played, even little bit of cricket, what cricket they are talking about? I know what the cricket they are talking about. They want to do cricket, and then they have baseless rumors saying that the president doesn't want to conduct the game of cricket. I want to do cricket in a proper way. I don't want anybody just coming and playing and just going back, you know, because there are certain rules and regulations have to be followed. Now I want to ask one more thing. I mean, for the last 25 years, I mean, we've got so much funding from the board. Where is the funding gone? Why we don't have a single ground? Apart from the Gymkhana and apart from the Upal cricket ground, there are no other grounds. Please, can I ask, where are the other grounds? Why are we not having more grounds?